Yes, hi again. This is George Larakis, and today I would like to discuss about the unit circle. The unit circle is a very valuable tool that you will use in math. And as you can understand, the unit circle, it's a circle, as you can see here, that its radius is 1, and in the x-axis we measure the cos, and in the y-axis we measure the sine. So now I want to show you something which it has to do with the use of the unit circle in order to find the cos and sine of angles with respect to some other angles. So, I mean, let's say we have this angle here. Let's call it again A. So, I mean, the cos of this angle, it's this here. And the sine of this angle is this here. So now let's go and draw an angle A here. This is A. So now let's find also the cos and sine of this angle here. So if you bring again the perpendicular from this point to this point, we have that this here, it's now the cos of this angle here, and this here, so this here, is the sine of this angle here. If you see, you have that, let's say this here, which is the cos of A, which is this segment here from here to here, it's equal with this here, which is what? This is the sine of this angle here. So where, how much is this angle here? This angle here, since we said that this is A, this angle here is 90 minus A. So, and now if you take the this here, from here to here, which is what? This is the sine of this angle. The sine of angle A is, you know, if you bring the projection from here to here, is this segment here. So this here, the sine of A, is equal with what? Let me tell you, it's equal with what? It's equal with, I mean, this, from here to here, it's the same with this here. Which is what? What is this here? This is the cos of this angle here. Because the projection from this point to the cos axis comes here. So this small segment here is the cos of this angle here. Like this angle here, which is what again? Is 90 minus A. So what have we saw here? We see that angles that they sum up to 90 degrees, they interchange cos and sine. So that's the most important thing of the unit circle. I mean, what's the most important thing? Is that if you are able to see these things on the unit circle, you don't have to remember anything. So you can find relations between angles, and you don't have to remember formulas like, you know, like what's the relationship between angles that their sum is 90 degrees or their sum is 180 or, you know, any other combinations. Let me, for example, and you can always relate these angles to the, let's say, to the basic angles or the reference angles, which are always in the first quadrant. I mean, this here, it's the first quadrant, the second, the third, and this is the fourth quadrant. So you can always refer any angle to the cos and sine of any angle to the two angles in the first quadrant. So, I mean, let me erase again this and show you one last thing, and that will be it for this lesson. So, let's say, for example, you want to find what's the cos of this angle here. So, like this angle here. So you want to find the cos. So what do you do? And you want to express it in terms of the trigonometric numbers that are in this quadrant here, the first quadrant. So that means that the angle is between 0 and 90 degrees. So, I mean, what you can see here is what is the cos. The cos, it will be this segment here, from this point to this point. So, if you see here, that if you do this angle here, which this and this are equal, and you bring this, you have that this segment and this segment, they are equal, but the one is positive, because from here to here is positive, and from here to here is negative, so the one is positive and the other is negative. But as segments, you know, this and this, they are equal. So, and the one, it's the cos of this angle, and the other is the cos of this angle. So that means that the cos of this angle here, I call this, is equal with the negative cos of this here. And of course, these two angles, if you see, like this angle and this angle here, like this small angle here, are what? They're angles that they sum up to 180 degrees. So that means that angles that they sum up to 180 degrees, they have opposite causes, their cosines. So that means that the, again, angles that they sum up to 180 degrees, they have opposite cosines. And let's say also you have to find, let's say you want to find the sine of this angle here. What you have to do is you have to bring the projection, so from this point here to the sine axis, so it intersects here, so that means that the sine of this angle here is this segment here. And of course, if you can see, if you bring the perpendicular line from this point to here to the sine axis, it will come approximately to the same point. Actually, you know, if the circle was perfect, it would come in the exact point. So it means that these two angles, they have what? They have the same sine. So actually, angles that they have angles that their sum is equal with 180 degrees, they have, as we see, opposite cosines and the same sine. I mean, you know, let's say also, you know, you have this and this angle. So, I mean, let's say you have this angle here now, this, let's say this here. And you want to find the cos and the sine of this angle. So, you see that, I mean, in order to bring, to find the cos and the sine of this, what we do is you bring from this point the perpendicular to the cos axis. And so if you see, like, if you bring now an angle like this, which is, you know, this angle here is equal with this angle here, you see that the cos of this angle and of this angle, it's what? It's the same, because, you know, the cos of the one is this and the cos of the other is also this. And if you want to find the sines, what do you do? So you see that the sine of all this, it's, you know, it's this segment here, from here to here, and the cos of this here, it's, you know, this segment here. So you see that they're equal, just the one is on the positive sign and the other is in the negative, so that means that the signs are opposite. So that means that angles that sum up to 360 degrees, they have the same cos and opposite signs. So this way you can play around the unit circle and, you know, like measuring these segments. And of course, the more accurate is, the more perfect is your unit circle, the, you know, the easiest is to see these relations. And this way you don't have again to remember all these you know, like rules that relate angles among themselves. So that's about it. Thank you for taking the time to view this video, and I hope you find it useful, and bye for now.